Good evening, Cukes and ukulele lovers out there. We got a great show lined up for you this evening for International Ukulele or Play Your Ukulele Day. So we got a lot of things. I'm looking at my green room right now. I got we're stacked up here. I got a special guest. I got coming on. I got a special. I think we have a another special segment from Bart, a multi-segment adventure that we were setting up early. So we got a lot of different things. So today is not only International Play Your Ukulele Day, but it's also Groundhog Day. So if you're watching, we don't care, right? What Punxsutawney Phil says, but we got our ukuleles, so we are golden. We are good to go. So if you are watching over on Facebook, give me a like, share, comment. Let me know that you're here. If you have a ukulele story to tell me and you want me to read it, comment on it, how you play or outside of here, since it's Play Your Ukulele Day. Let me know. Let me see those comments. If you're over on YouTube, give me a like and a subscribe over there. I really appreciate that, trying to get that channel going a little bit. So I had mentioned in the email that I sent out to everyone that we are going to do a little Blue Hawaii Pearly Shells mashup. I think we should just get right into it. So we're going to use the turnaround. So if you made a copy, I hope you have a copy of Pearly Shells or Blue Hawaii so we can go from side to side. I had downloaded it. Oh, we got, man, it's just stacking up in that green room. I can't wait to see all you people out there. All right, so we're going to get right to it. So we're going to do, for all you out there, so we're going to do Blue Hawaii. We're on page 37. If you made a copy, or you can try to remember, I don't know, we're going to go back and forth. So I'm going to go all the way through Blue Hawaii. Then we're going to do a little turnaround, and we're going to do a little Pearly Shells. And then maybe we'll think we'll go back to Blue Hawaii and we'll give it a go. But the turnaround, remember, since it's in the same key, the turnaround in G is A7, D7, G. We can use that as a little intro. I'm thinking Pearly Shells. Let me try that again. Night and you. All right, there I got it. Not the way to start the show off. Night and you in blue Hawaii. The night is heavenly, and you are heaven to me. Lovely you in blue Hawaii, with all nice loveliness, there should be love. Come with me while the moon is on the sea. The night is young, and so are we. Dreams come true in blue Hawaii, and mine could all be true this magic night of night with you. Turn around to Pearly Shells. Shining in the sun, covering the shore. When I see I've got a kiss for you, and I've got more left over for stars that twinkles in the blue, pearly shells from the ocean, shining in the sun, covering the shore. When I see turnaround just takes you right into it. So I've got a very special guest I'm going to bring on, Mr. Herm Friedman. How are you? Oh, I caught you mid-drink.
I'm here.
I got it. You're here.
There's no such thing as mid-drink. It's all drink.
Is
for Greg. It's all drink. This one is for Greg.
What you drinking tonight, Herm? Your usual?
The usual. I want to say hello to everybody. Hello to Mary, the intrepid Mary down in down south someplace. I don't know where she is, but she's always there.
Alexandria, Virginia.
What a good fan and stalwart ukulele, you know, person. But then again, our group, there was nothing like our group, and we have all suffered. I say
yes, but we're still doing it. But I want to remind you of something. Do you know where we? I got a trivia question for you. I got a Cukes trivia question for you. Do you know where we were 3 years ago today?
Tell me, man.
3 years ago.
3 years ago.
We were
at the theater in Norwalk. What?
Yes, we were on the Wall Street Theater stage making the debut, the international debut of the Cukes, performing live.
Wow. Is that all? It seemed to me like we, you know, that was like 10 or 15 years ago. I'm afraid.
That's what it was. It came up in my memories in Facebook.
Yes, and time drags when you're in prison. And not that I'm in prison. I have a you know, Phyllis and
you have Phyllis.
The Cukes and my house. Yes, absolutely. It's but I tell you, like I told you before, it's hard to get the mojo going. My hat goes off to you and Bart and Terry and Tom, Big Tom. Where's Long Tom? And all the people, Bill and Vicky, who just don't quit. I mean, you guys are great. But it's
we got to keep it going. We got to keep doing it, right?
Yeah, we got to keep it going. Well, for that reason, I picked out. You know, I know you asked me to do something, and I'm very. It's tough to get my mojo going, but I got it going for you, Steve. And
okay.
I picked out a special song, "Undecided." Now, to me, it was a hit. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? It was a hit back in the 50s, but my friend didn't seem to remember it. I hope you guys remember. It's in the Blue
I don't know.
Book.
Well, you got to play it for me, and then I'll tell you if I remember
it. You should be, of course, strumming. I'm going to play it, but, you know, I'm working on my second scotch, and I can barely see. I can barely see the book.
All right, you go for it.
I'm
going to
play
out.
This tune.
All right, go for it.
Thank you, Steve. Here we go. This is called Undecided.
First you say you do, and then you don't. And then you say you will, and then you won't. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? You wanna play, and then it's no. And then you say you stay, and then you go. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? I've been sitting on a fence, it doesn't make much sense. You keep me in suspense, and you know it. And then you promise to return, you know I really burn. I guess I'll never learn, I show it that you have a heart. And if you're kind, don't keep us apart, make up your mind. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? I've been sitting on a fence, it doesn't make much sense. You keep me in suspense and you know it. You promise to return, you know I really burn. I guess I'll never learn and I shall wait. Oh, if you have a heart and if you're kind, don't keep us apart, make up your mind. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do?
Go.
Excellent. I want to wait. Am I hearing some woo woos? I don't know. I heard a woo woo in the back.
Yeah, that was Phyllis? Phyllis in the basement. That was Phyllis in the basement. She gave me a woo woo. That's why I married her, you know.
That's why you married her, and that's why you're playing the ukulele. Is that's it Phyllis's playing, fault?
That's why she's playing the ukulele. But I tell you, the biggest thrill I ever got was the first night that we played together with you. And I was actually playing music with Phyllis, you know,
yes.
And that was wonderful. Now, if we go back 50 years, Phyllis and I have been, and go back more than that, back in the folk music days, Phyllis did, you know, she played folk guitar.
Okay.
And, you know, like that.
So it's her fault you're playing ukulele, not...
Or is it, you say, man.
I don't know. You came as a package, so I didn't know, you know,
that's
who,
right.
Who started nice, first nice with time. The uke.
There you go. That's right. Well, that was fun on tonight, man. Very, very
I'm
nice.
Glad you where's, could join us, Herm.
And where's Bart? Where is Bart? Where's your
Well, baby? Maybe I'm going to bring Bart in right now. I'm going to add Bart in. Hey, Bart.
Oh, good. So let me hang a little bit.
Herm, that was great. It's great to see
you. Oh, Chef of the Future.
What?
It's Chef of the Future. Oh, yes, Chef. It's the Chef of the Future.
I'm uking and cuking and cooking tonight.
Yeah, it's a whole thing. So I'm gonna tease it right now. We're gonna have a little tease. I'm gonna do another song and then we're gonna come back to you, Bart. So I'm gonna do it that way.
I'm playing.
But uking and cuking and cooking is a good name for the album.
Oh, uking, cooking.
Say again.
Wait, I forgot myself. Cooking, and cooking. And yeah. I love. Cuking, by the way, I love the picture behind you. The
original artwork behind you, over your shoulder.
It's from the
over
same series.
That,
that's
love
from
that
the same
one too.
You know, I gotta try and you know.
love
is that
your
one
artwork.
For sale?
I love your
They're all what? They're all for sale.
They're all for sale.
From my sales, right? That's okay.
Yeah.
They're all for sale.
All right. So,
listen.
All right, we're gonna do.
I'm just talking to you. I'm. This is international, isn't it?
It's worldwide.
Isn't
it's worldwide.
There you go. Look at him in his hat. You're unbelievable.
Stay tuned. All right.
Stay tuned. Stay tuned.
You're gonna learn.
You don't
want
to miss this.
You're gonna learn something about food that you never knew that you forgot about. Tonight. Oh yeah.
Does it go
all
with
right.
this? That's hey, great. This
it
is
works
great.
For that too.
That's for great. All right. Thank you, Herm. Good. It's good to see you. I'm glad thank you could you. Join us.
Thank you, Steve. Thanks, Bart.
Anytime. Anytime. The invitation's always open. Anytime. Oh, you just froze on
that's
me.
Good.
All right. I'm thanks, Herm. Yeah, no, not anymore. All right. Have a good night. All right, so we're going to move on to Stand By Me, and then we got a special. Yeah, I know it's a little bit of a tease, but we got Bart. You saw a little bit of something that's going on. We got something cooking. We've been, I didn't want to say cooking, but it's actually cooking. All right, so we're going to do a little Stand By Me, a little Ben E. King, a Lieber Stover. Jerry and Lieber and Stoller song. Go one more time through the chords is the intro. Stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Stand by me. Oh, stand. Stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky we look upon should tumble and fall, and the mountains shall crumble to the sea, oh, I won't cry. No, I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand, stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand. Stand by me. Stand by me. The darling, darling, stand by me. Stand by me. Oh, stand. Stand by me. Stand by me. Whenever I'm in trouble, won't you stand by me? Stand by me. Stand by me. Stand by me. Stand by me. A little stand by me. All right, Bart, you ready to go? You ready to go, Bart?
Yeah, let's go for it.
Let's go for it.
This is like shooting the moon. This is like trying to get, do it all. Just disaster or whatever happens here. But Herm, great to see you, man. And tonight I'm going to be yuking and I'm going to be cooking.
All right. So how are you starting it off right now?
Well, I think I'm going to do the song first because the cooking is going to take a little extra time.
Okay.
But let me just talk about the cooking just for a second. I mean, we've all eaten, you know, for years now. We've gotten used to the comfort of having microwave popcorn. And I think we've gotten to, you know, it's so easy. You put it into the microwave, and you sort of forget about it. Then you
burn it, and your house smells like, you know, like it's been on fire for 3 days.
Good point. And what I'm going to show you tonight, it still has that potential. But let me tell you, we've gotten so used to that bland taste of that microwave popcorn, we forgot, you know, what heart-stopping saturated oil, you know, really tastes like when you add it to popcorn. So I figured let me just show everybody an easy way, almost as easy as putting that bag in that microwave, just an easy way to make that saturated fat popcorn again. Sorry, I did not have my prop, but here it is. Tonight, I'm going to show you the finer points of how to make.
Oh, classic.
Dippy pop.
Classic.
Yes.
I can't wait. It is classic.
And I want to tell you something. You've all forgotten how good this is. So I will be back with a later segment later teaching everybody exactly how to make this perfect. All right?
And you're going to expand on your last song, that time you cooked. You're doing a little expansion on that.
Yes, that's right. I decided I'd go back at it in a song I did a few weeks ago when I was last cooking. And I brought in, I got some people I found who are going to actually help me sing the song. So let's just cross my fingers and see if all right. this works. Steve, if you'll give me a little
I'll
picture,
take, I'll
doing.
Get you all nice and big so we can see all your well, quartet
I can
back
see
up.
It, so I can see yeah. this again. All right. So here goes nothing. The boys and I are going to sing you a nice song. Short, but nice. Come on.
Oh, I wish I were an Oscar Mayer wiener. That is what I truly like to be. Cause if I were an Oscar Mayer wiener, everyone would be in love with me. With me. Everyone would be in love with me. Me.
Excellent. You better turn that off so. Before we get that commercial going.
All right. So, Steve.
You don't need the harmonizer like I got. You got your backup singers right there.
They are. Those boys are for hire for nothing.
Now what do you got going on here?
What?
For the longest time.
Oh, right. Oh, wait a second. Goodbye, boys. Oh, that doesn't stop them either. They just keep going.
All right, I'm gonna stop you right now. So get up to that kitchen and start making your jiffy pop. Okay. I was so taken by that, I forgot what our next song is going to be. You Gotta Hide Your Love Away, page 283. This was John in his Bob Dylan phase, I think is what he was quoted on saying. 283. All right. You got to hide your love away. All right. So there's a one quick note on this song. All right. Right before the hey. All right. I don't know if they did this because of economy of song or space on the page, but right before the hey, we're going to play that D chord two times. All right. So it's actually two measures leading into that. Right. And we're in 6/8 here. So we got a nice little beat. Now that I found the beat. All right. Ready? One, two, three, one. Here I stand, hand in hand, turn my face to the wall. If she's gone, now can't go on feeling 2 feet tall. Everywhere people stare, each end. Every day I can see them laugh at me. I can hear them say, hey, you've got to hide your love away. Hey, you've got to hide your love away. How can I even try? I can never win. Hearing them and seeing them in the state I'm in. How can she say to me, love will find a way? Gather round all you clowns, let me hear you say, to hide your love away. Hey, you've got to hide your love away. A little little whistle at the end. I hope you don't hear my bird. Whenever I start whistling, my African gray likes to whistle along. We like to play little whistle games. All right, we're going to go right to the monkeys, and then I'm going to bring in another guest on this. I think I got Uncle Zach in the queue. I think after the monkeys, we'll bring in Uncle Zach. Say hi. I just like packed up show there. All right, so page 123. All right, so we have to do a little arranging on this song as well. All right, let me find it first. So Neil Diamond wrote this song, if you didn't see that. All right, and it was the best-selling single of 1967. All right, so what we're going to do, D. All right, so we're gonna go through the whole song. All right, and then it takes a little solo, and it just goes from D to A chord, right? All right, so just kind of follow me along, all right? So you're going to see, you know, so, and then we're going to do a little, you know, that little repeat and fade on the end. I think I finally worked out how this song kind of is structured, right? I thought love was only true in fairy tales. Not enough for else, but not for me. Love was out to get me, ba-da-ba-da, waiting there to see. Ba-da-ba-da, disappointment haunted all my dreams. Then I saw her face, now I'm a believer. Not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love, ooh, I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried. I thought love was more or less a given thing. Seems the more I gave, the less I got. What's the use of trying? All I get is pain. When I needed sunshine, I got rain. Then I saw her face. Then I'm a believer. Not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love, ooh, I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried. What's love? What's use of? What's the use of trying? Ba-da-ba-da. All I get is pain. When I needed sunshine, I got rain. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love. I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm a believer, yeah, 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 yeah. I'm a believer, yeah, 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 yeah. I'm in love, ooh, I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried. Or something like that. All right, Uncle Zach, you ready?
Ever.
Ready Aloha. As ever. Aloha, how are you? Happy International Play Your Ukulele Day.
Yes, this is. I've been playing ukulele all day long. Not really, but trying to recover from all the snowblower work that I've been doing.
Oh, you at least had a snowblower. I was actually.
Yeah, we didn't shoveling. Have anybody to plow it, so I was out there. I only had to do it like three times to get all the snow, but it was fun. I got exercise anyway.
Well, I definitely got my workout in today. That's for sure.
This is true. This is very, very true. I hope everybody is well and safe and just enjoying the strum. That's the whole idea.
That's
of this.
The whole thing. I mean, you know, we always got, you know, I was like, you know, they say, you know, 6 more weeks of winter. I was like, international play, we got 52 more weeks of ukulele. I mean, let's
That's
be
right.
about it.
That's right. That's right. So just go through your collection, play each and every one, and enjoy the fact that they all have a different voice.
A different voice, yes.
No matter how many you have, they all have a different voice, and there's special songs that sound good for each one.
So do you have a song for us tonight?
I do have a song with a story, and I you may have heard the story, but the story kind of sets up the song. When on my birthday, my son invited me down to his college down in Carlisle and Dickinson because Leon Redbone was playing. And to make a long story short, I ended up in Leon's dressing room playing songs and singing with him. So finally, at the last part, I said, you know, Mr. Redbone, there's one song that you do that I really, really love, and I wonder if you could do a few bars. I said, the song is Sugar. And he looked at me and he goes, you know, I can never remember the chords to that song. He turns to his piano player and says, Paul, why don't you go out there on stage and bang out this tune for this young fella? So we all move out onto the main stage of the opera house, and Paul starts playing Sugar, and I'm playing along with it, and Leon's singing it, and it was just a wonderful, wonderful moment. So I'm going to try to do that tonight. It's all right. Really kind of a cool song.
All right, take it away.
Do I know what I've done? Found the word, just the one, that takes the place of the one I used to call baby doll. It ain't new, it ain't old, but if you do what you're told, you'll find the answer if you take a look. Mr. Webster Dictionary book, the word is sugar. I call my baby my sugar. I never maybe my sugar. But my sugar is so confectionary funny. She never pleads for my money. But when she feeds me on honey, she gets to me every time. I'd make a million trips to her lips if I were a bee, cause they are sweeter than any candy for me. She's granulated sugar. I never cheat on my sugar. I'm too sweet on my sugar. That sugar baby of mine. So confectionary funny. I'd make a million trips to her lips if I were a bee, cause they are sweeter than any candy for me. She's granulated sugar. I never cheat on my sugar. That's why I'm sweet on my sugar. The sugar baby of mine. Thank you, Leon.
Thank you, Uncle Zach. Excellent.
Cool song. Cool song.
Yes.
All righty. I'm going to let you get back to the book. Hope everybody.
Yeah, I don't know. I think Bart might be. I don't know. Not yet. No. You're like showing. You're like.
He doesn't want to come in and talk to me. He and Herb. I haven't seen these guys. Well, I saw Bart. Bring him in if they're there.
Herb, you want to come back in and say hi to Uncle Zach?
Yeah.
I got you back. Look at this. I got a four shot going on.
Hey here. Guys, how you doing?
Hey guys.
Zach Meister.
Yes, sir.
Did you miss my tune? Come on.
Hey. No, I got your tune. I even wrote up there. Great job. Great song. And I was playing along. Except I couldn't get the second chord.
Well,
I know the first chord was G, but the second chord I couldn't get. What was it? It was Fa?
G major 7.
It was what?
G major 7, Mr.
Oh, major 7. Oh, you tricky little devil. And Bart, how's it coming? How's the
All right, but then it was C9.
C9? Well, we could try that one too. Bart, how's the recording coming?
Yeah. Well, I blew up my computer, so I have to actually waiting for my new computer to come. But we can talk. I'll bring it right over.
You never sent me any material to work on.
No, because I truly my computer blew up. I am now working with a little iPhone and an iPad, and it just doesn't work to do recordings with it.
Well, as long as we're all strumming, that's all that counts.
That's all that counts.
I'm going to let all Steve bring the show back. Good to see you guys.
All right. Thank you, Uncle Zach.
Herm, I got to do a trip to the studio. I'll give you a call. Aloha.
Aloha.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, guys. We'll be back.
Aloha. I have to go back to my cooking, Steve.
You have to go back to your cooking. All right. So we're going to move on to the Blue Book, and then I think I'm going to bring Terry on after this song, because I'm stacking everything. Look at it, stacking up in here. I got to scroll down to see all these faces tonight. So we're going to move on to the Blue Book. We're going to do Never Fall in Love Again, Burt Bacharach and Hal David song for their musical Promises, Promises, but really made famous by Miss Dionne Warwick. Who was kind of Burt Bacharach's muse. All right, so just follow me towards the end. I'm going to take a little repeat where the solo is. We'll come back to the don't tell me what it's all about at the end. What do you get when you fall in love? A girl who tries to burst your bubble. That's what you get. You're real in trouble. I'll never fall in love again. I'll never fall in love again. What do you get when you kiss a girl? You catch enough germs to catch pneumonia. After you do, she'll leave your phone. I'll never fall in love again. I'll never fall in love again. Don't tell me what it's all about, 'cause I've been good and I'm glad I'm out. Out of those chains that bind you. That is why I'm here to remind you. What do you get when you fall in love? You only get lies and pains and sorrow. So for it to last until tomorrow, I'll never fall in love again. Fall in love again. Back to the bridge. Don't tell me what it's all about, 'cause I've been there and I'm glad I'm out. Out of those chains, those chains that bind me. That is why I'm here to remind you, what do you get when you fall in love? You only get pain and sorrow. So what, at least until tomorrow, I'll never fall in love again. I'll never fall in love again. I was going to try to figure out a way to say, you know, you catch enough germs to catch COVID, but I couldn't come up with a rhyme, so I left it as it was. All right, Terry, how you doing tonight, Terry? You're on mute. Unmute you. You're on mute. Oh, we're going to try it again. Let's see. All right, how about now? All right, I'm going to let Terry work this out while we figure that out. Well, I'm going to jump over to Tom, actually, now that I got Tom over here. So, how are you doing, Tom?
Stephen, how are you?
I am well. How are you doing?
Great. I was in Kansas City to watch the Buffalo Bills lose to Kansas City. You know, I'm a big Buffalo Bills fan.
I know you're a huge Buffalo Bill fan, but they had a great season.
There was an 80,000 stadium. There was only 22,000 of us. It was very well, you know, we were all socially distanced and whatnot. And it was just too bad. But, you know, they had a great season. Kansas City's awesome. And it's going to be a great Super Bowl next week.
I hope so. I hope Kansas City beats. I know it might be ruffling, you know, little Tom Brady feathers around here. But
that's true.
I kind of hope they beat Tom.
Yes, I agree. That is true. All right, we're going to do an island song and go along with popcorn. I don't see why we can't have a tequila, and we'll have a little margarita.
Margarita. All right, take it away.
Thanks, Steve. Doing a great job as usual. We're going to do this in the key of D. So here we go. Margaritaville, Jimmy Buffett. I'm nibbling on sponge cake. I'm watching the sun bake. All of those tourists covered with oil. I'm strumming my four string on my front porch swing. The smell of shrimp, they're beginning to boil. Wasted away again in Margaritaville. Searching for my lost sugar of salt. Some people claim that there's a worm on the blame, but I know it's nobody's fault. I don't know the reason I stayed here all season. Nothing to show but this brand new tattoo. But it's a real beauty, a Mexican cutie. How it got here, I haven't a clue. Wasted away again in Margaritaville. Searching for my lost sugar of salt. Some people claim that there's a worm on the blame. Now I think, hell, it could be my fault. I blew up my flip-flop. I stepped on a pop-top. I cut my heel, had a cruise on back home. But there's booze in the blender, and soon it will render that frozen concoction, it helps me hang on. Here we go now. I wasted away again in Margaritaville. Searching for my lost shaker of salt, 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 salt. Some people claim that there's a worm on the blame, but I know it's my own damn fault. Yes, and Some people claim that there's a woman to blame, and I know it's my own damn fault. Mr. Jimmy Buffett.
Mr. Jimmy Buffett. You, now, you before the show, you came on. You gave me a little bit. Can we tease this little bit of news, possibly?
Yes. Before the COVID, or a couple of months ago, we used to get together at a big warehouse at 698 West Avenue. My tenant is leaving on March 2nd, so we'll be able to come into the building on March 9th. I think that's the Tuesday. So that's some good news a month from today. So it's at least something to look forward to.
It's a month from today. So
Yes. So that might be something good to look forward to for the group. You know.
All right. I look forward to it because I miss being amongst all of everyone. So
agree.
We'll still put our masks on. We'll still do the whole safe thing, but we'll maybe at least be out and we can actually see each other. All right. Thanks, Tom.
See you, Stevie. Oh well.
Okay, so I'm going to do Between the Devil and the Deep Blue Sea, and then we're going to try for Terry, and maybe I'll get Jerry. I got Jerry, and I got a whole bunch of people. Like, I just hanging out here tonight. I couldn't believe it. I wasn't even sure if anyone was going to show up tonight. So The Devil in the Deep Blue Sea, Harold Arlen, who actually did all the music, wrote Over the Rainbow as well for The Wizard of Oz, did all the songs, songwriting for Wizard of Oz. But as we know, a great ukulele fan of Mr. George Harrison did a wonderful recording of this, and we all know George was a huge ukulele fan. So I think I may try a little kazoo solo, even though I've been told that someone in my house might try to steal my kazoo because they don't like the sound of it. So, but too bad. Terry, let's see if we got that mic working now. You're still on mute. There we go.
Hey.
How are you doing tonight?
I'm good. My back is sore from shoveling for 2 days, but other than that, I'm fine.
I didn't bother shoveling for 2 days. I figured, you know what? I'm just gonna power through it today. I was just gonna let it all pile up.
Smart man.
Because it was gonna take me either 2 hours to do and then 2 hours again, and I figured
I know.
It took me, you know, so whatever.
Yeah.
So you got a song for us tonight, or?
Yeah, I do. A 5'2", Eyes of Blue, in the Yellow Book, 82.
All right, take it away, and then I got something special for everyone after you're done.
All right. Yeah, so that's so good to see Herm and Zach and everybody singing away. So I just thought we'd do a nice light little ditty that's always fun to play on the ukulele. And we're going to go twice through. And at the top of the second time through, you got to do your trumpet on mute imitation. Okay. No, we're not going to use our kazoos. We're just going to use our best muted trumpet imitation. All right. Ready?
Excellent job. So before you leave, I'm going to try to play this video. I put a little video together with the track that you sent me. So I'm going to play that along on the road again, and it's kind of self-explanatory. So hopefully
cool.
It plays. All right. So let
cool.
me. I'm going to hit it now and see what happens. Wishing we were at the horseshoe with everyone. So a little on the road again, starting off with me. And then we're going to segue into one we recorded over at the Horseshoe and some pictures to remind us of where we're going to be, hopefully very soon. Looking forward to it. Can't wait to make music with you all again with a drink in our hand and the crowd singing along with us. On the road again, just can't wait to be on the road again. Life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again.
On the road again. Going places that
I'm
Woohoo is right. I can't wait to get on the road again with you all. It was nice looking through those old pictures, those pictures from when we were, I think a couple of them, seeing some other faces I haven't seen in a long time. That will be up on the YouTube channel. I think I set it to debut at like after the show tonight. So if you want to watch it again, look for your picture, go for it. So I'm going to bring Jerry on now. Jerry, you asked if there was any drum, and I believe there was drum in that.
Well, there was a photo of me, which I appreciate. And it all comes together, I would say, with a little bit of percussion. It was subtle, but I think actually people were following it.
It sounded great. I thought, you know, the sound of the strumming and the singing, it was great. But I remember you asked me, it was like, was there any drum in that? And I'm like, yes, there's some drum in that. And I had to get your picture up there. I mean, you hang out with us, so it's, you know, you're
well, thanks. I mean, listen, that was really a great, that was an amazing video. I mean, and I think it really reminds everybody. It's a pretty, you know, special group, and we're all very lucky to be in it. Okay.
I'm lucky to hang out with all of you. So, all right. So I'm going to move on to a little, Will You Love Me Tomorrow? All right. So, page 389. And then I don't know, is Bart almost ready to come back on and to give us a little, yeah. All right. After this song, Bart, after this song, I'm going to bring you on. I'll bring on this. So we're going to do a little Carole King and Jerry Goffin. This actually was written for the Shirelles, and it was the first all female black group to go number one. So a little honor of little Black History Month there, I thought. Nice little tidbit on that. But it was the first all black girl group. Actually, yeah, all black girl group to hit a number one song. So, here we go. Tonight, you're mine completely. You give your love. Sweetly tonight, the light of love is in your eyes. Will you still love me tomorrow? Is this the lasting treasure, or just a moment of pleasure? Can I believe the magic in your sight? Will you still love me tomorrow? Tonight the words unspoken, you say that I'm the only one, but will my heart be broken when the night meets the morning sun? I'd like to know that your love is a love I can sure of. So tell me now, and I won't ask again. Will you still love me tomorrow? Will you still love me tomorrow? Okay, so let's bring Bart back on. I gotta find you. You disappeared, and you moved around on my camera there. My little. Okay, what do you got for us, Bart? Where are we along on this cooking segment here?
This is all right. This is your cooking chef here, and I must say this may be my last cooking session.
Oh, come on!
No, I gotta tell you, there's no production money in this, and it's very hard to pull these production.
Well, we gotta work on some sponsorship if we're gonna do this. I mean, let's be real. Jiffy Pop should be throwing us a little, you know, for the 100 people that are watching. You know.
So I want you then, Steve, after the show, and I'm gonna show everybody, by the way, how to replace that ubiquitous, you know, air popped corn, or that popcorn that we do in our microwave that we've all gotten so used to, and you've forgotten this product. And I must tell you, this is
where'd you find that? I haven't seen Jiffy Pop.
Yeah, it was very old, and it says sell by 1979. Well, anyway, here it is. And I want you to know something. The secret to doing this well is, well, I will reveal it actually in, I condensed the cooking time because I figured this is a music show. And the last thing everybody wants to see, is 10 minutes of air popping that corn. But I have condensed.
All right, I'm gonna bring you in full screen. I'm going to bring you in full screen.
Okay.
Hit play.
So here we go. I am going to take you through the process of how to properly do your Jiffy Pop popcorn. And I'm going to have to try to do this as, let me see. Okay, in the booth, please start the videotape. There we are. There. Now you carefully take the lid off the popcorn. Don't stick your finger through the aluminum. And read those instructions that are on the back of the lid. You read the instructions, you do fine. Medium, low heat. Put your corn on the burner, let it cook, and look, you know, you have to wait. Be patient. Get a beer and just sit back and wait. Listen for a sizzle. When you hear the sizzle, begin to shake. You shake that corn. Let it start to pop a little. Then shake again. And then wait, and now shake again. And if you keep shaking and you're patient, you get, in the end, look at this. You take a knife to it, you cut it open, and you pour it into a bowl. And I gotta tell you something. In the end, there it is, Steve.
Your shaking skills, I mean, if you practice strumming, I think your shaking skills will come in handy for this.
Thank you. and by the way, one little tidbit, nice thing to add, because now, believe me, it has all that saturated oil taste and butter in it and salt that's already there. So all you do is add a little pinch of Parmigiano Reggiano cheese. And sprinkle this, you know, into your popcorn. Mix it a little bit, and I gotta tell you,
excellent. I'm gonna bring Greg in. I think Greg might have a comment for this. I'm gonna bring Greg in on here. Greg, what do you think about this?
Oh right. Well, there you go. I'm just saying. The Parmigiano was the thing. There it goes. That's what it sounds like when you add it. It's perfect. Bart,
it's perfect.
I'm going to throw away the duck and the squab that I bought for the weekend. I'm just going to make that.
Yeah. It's a wonderful meal. I must tell you.
It looks great.
It's not at all fattening. Yeah. Yeah. It'll stop your heart a little sooner than usual, but it's wonderful. Really, I'm not even going to give this to the dogs.
You're not even. The dogs aren't even going to get to sample
this one, right?
Yeah. All right, Bart.
And Steve, next week I think I'm going to come back with just music.
You inspire me, Bart.
Just music next week, Bart.
I think so. Yeah, just music next week.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Bart.
I don't know any other things. I just run through my whole repertoire.
I think you can actually cook better than you giving yourself credit for, but
it's all
all right. Thank you, Bart. So, Greg, are you sitting down at the piano, Greg?
I am. I mean, I don't know what I'm doing here, but I was trying to play along with some of the people and figuring out the keys as they were playing, and all I ended up doing was ended up in E flat and B flat, so it didn't work.
Okay, well, the next song we're doing is the MTA song. There's okay. only three well, chords.
Well, I'll give you the beginning of this old folk song that I think you all know that you might like. I don't know if this is going to be loud enough. You tell me. Can you hear this?
I can hear it.
Okay. You know that old folk song?
It's not ringing a bell yet, but...
You haven't got it yet?
I know I got it. I just had it, but
what is it?
I can't. It's just it's eluding me. It's just
tall and tenor.
Oh yeah, Girl from Ipanema. That's one of Herm's favorite songs. She's always wanted to play that one on the Uke.
Yeah. It's got
making us think of sunnier days of the beaches down in Rio. All right, Greg. All right, so we're going to go to the good old folk song, the MTA. Thank you, Greg. All right, so the MTA, right? So this Kingston Trio, the Kingston Trio, 1949. It was actually a slogan, campaign song for the progressive candidate Walter A. O'Brien when he was running for mayor of Boston. It was a little protest, all right? So I'm going to do my best on the lyrics here. We got like five verses and a lot of words, and I'm just going to warn you, just hold on tight, sing along as best you can, because these lines get all kind of mixed up. About a man named Charlie and a tragic, fateful day. He put 10 cents in his pocket and his wife and his family, and he rode in the MTA. Well, he never returned, and he never returned, and he never returned, and the fate was fairly learned. He may ride forever on the streets of Boston, and the man who never returned. Charlie handed in his dime at a Kendall Square station, and he changed for the Jacob Plain. When he got there, conductor told him one more nickel, and Charlie couldn't get off the train. Well, he never returned, and he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever on the streets of Boston, he's a man who never returned. Now all night Charlie goes through the tunnels, what's become of me? How can I afford to see my sisters in a town? There we go. And he never returned, and he never returned, and his fate was still unlearned. He may ride forever on the streets of Boston, he's a man who never returned. Now Charlie's wife goes down to Solis Fair, and he faces it every day. Let me start that verse again. Charlie's wife goes down to the Scully station where the big, 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 and he never can wail to the window. let's just go to the verse. And he never returned, and he never returned. His faith is still unlearned. He may ride underneath the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returns. Last verse. Now the city of Boston thinks it it's so, since it said people have to pay. And the fight, the fair, increased the fight, and then they get Charlie off the MTA. Oh, he never returned, and he never returned, and the fate will do be learned. And he ride forever on the streets of Boston, he's the man who never returns. Let's do it again. And he never returns, and he never returns, and the fate still is unlearned. He rides underneath the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returns. Whoa. Those are always a lot of words. I knew I was going to run into trouble in that one. I just knew it. I pre-disastered it, but you're out there reading the lyrics, and hopefully you got it too. All right, so we're going to, last one in the blue book, we're going to do a little CCR, a little looking out my back door page. What page is that? 228. A lot of people think this song is about drugs, but it's not. At least that's what John Fogerty said. He wrote this song, looking out page 228. He wrote this song, was kind of inspired by the Dr. Seuss book, I Think I Saw It on Mulberry Street, that he would read to his son. So what we're going to do, how it's going to work. All right. So we're going to do first verse, second verse. We're going to do the bridge, right? So we'll take the second ending when it says next strain, and we're going to go trombone, tambourines and elephants playing in the band. Then we're going to go back to the beginning. You can take a solo if you want to play a kazoo, or whatever you want. Then we will do the bridge again. Then we will do the third verse. All right. That's how the song actually goes. I mean, there's a little interlude there in the beginning. And then we'll do a little do-do-do, looking out my back door. All right. So. Just got home from Illinois, back to front door, and oh boy, got to sit down, take a rest on the porch. Imagination sets in, pretty soon I'm singing, do, 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 looking out my back door. There's a giant doing cartwheels, statue wearing high heels, look at all the happy creatures dancing on the lawn. Dinosaur Victrola, listen to Buck Owens, do, 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 looking out my back door. Tambourines and elephants are playing in the band. Won't you take a ride on the flying spoon? Do, 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 wondrous apparition, provide imagination, do, 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 looking out my back door. Today I buy no sorrows, do, 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 looking out my back door. Forward trouble, Illinois, lock the front door, and oh boy, look at all the happy people dancing on the lawn. Bother me tomorrow, today I buy no sorrows. So, Uncle Zach, you got another one for us? You got another song for us, Uncle Zach? Oh, you're on mute. I just brought you in anyway. You're on mute, Uncle Zach.
I didn't want you to hear me playing in the background there.
Well, I don't hear you when you're not on. I don't hear you, so you don't have to worry about that.
So here's the thing. You know, Bart was talking about food, so I figured, well, maybe I should sing my food song.
I think you should.
And the story of the food song goes that it's really a parody of a parody of Alan Sherman did a song where he parodied Shake Hands With Your Uncle Mike, an old Irish tune, and changed all the names to Irish to Jewish names. So there was a Merowitz, Ferowitz, Handelman, Shandelman, Serber and Gerber and Steiger and Stone, Moskowitz, Lukowitz, Aarons and Barons, Simon, Feidman and Friedman and Cohn. So I decided that, you know what, I should do it with Italian names. But the problem was all the Italian names end like in the same vowel. So it was going to be a very short song and very boring. So I went downstairs and I said, I figured out I'll do something very near and dear to my heart, which is food. So I went down to my mom and I said, hey, you know, I'm writing this song about food. What are we having for Thanksgiving? And literally, that's where this list came from.
All right, take it away.
I suffered while at college. I ate in dining halls. And I had a case of agita that started every fall. Every night, a lousy meal, a midnight snack, and then early in the morning, I was on the John again. When the term was over and my heart burned at a peak, that's the only time I'd see some good food for a week. I'd drive up to the west side, and before I stopped the car, my mom leaned out the window and she hollers, don't go far. Go wash your hands and sit right down and have a bite to eat. There's cold cuts in the Frigidaire or ziti I can eat. And here's some eggplant parmesan left over from last night. So grab a plate and fill it up and eat to your heart's delight. Ravioli, cannoli, linguine, zucchini, fried eels, scondigli, pasta, vazzo, pepperoni, spumoni, onion, lasagna, put sausage and peppers and baccalà too. Hot tortellini with green fettuccine, some provolone, minestrone, and cavatelle. Peaches and vino, some hot cappuccino, prosciutto and figs. And a hot for your Dell. Have some gabagool, my boy, and here's some mozzarella. There's cavadils and tagliatelles, my nuts are hot as hell. There's broccoli rabe and supersade, we got it hot and sweet. And for a treat, have pizza free, cause there's still more to eat. Ravioli, cannoli, linguine, zucchini, fried eels, scongili, and pasta vazzola. Rollies, ramones, salami, lasagna, pasta, and peppers, and baccalà too. Hot tortellini with green fettuccine, some provolone, minestrone, and cabazzel. Peaches and vino, some hot cappuccino, prosciutto, and figs. And a hot for you, Dell. Have some galamad, my boy, and here's some aglio olio. I'll put some meatballs and bruschetta on a bag to take to school. Whenever you're on the road, my boy, wherever you may eat, when you come back, there'll always be a full dish at your seat. Abundanza.
Abundanza. Thank you, as always. We always love that song.
Now I gotta go get a snack. Well, now, I think I'll put. You know, there's. I'm gonna tell you the best kept secret of Italian food are sfugliatelle. I don't know if you know what sfugliatelle.
I know what sfugliatelle is. Come on, my name ends in an O. I mean, come
okay.
On.
Here's the thing. You go to A&S in Norwalk.
A&S has some wonderful stuff.
And you buy the frozen sfugliatelle. They sell them in two different sizes. They're frozen. You take those babies home, and whenever you're hungry, you take, I don't know, 2, 3, 4, whatever you think you can eat. You put them in the oven at 350 for 1 hour, and you got the best sfugliatelle you'll ever eat.
Well, they opened an A&S that's down the street from me, so maybe I'll have to check it out.
Go in there. You know what? Go in there and talk to, Oh, what's his name now? And tell him I said hello. Juan. Go in there and talk to Juan. Tell him Uncle Zach said hello and that I need to come up and see him. And to fix you up with some nice Fouilladel.
All right. Well, I'm gonna keep that in mind. I mean, between you and Bart, I mean, these cooking segments that we got going on here. I mean,
we could do a whole podcast
or something. I mean,
a whole corner we could do. A whole corner.
All right, Uncle Zach. Thank you.
Okay. Aloha, everybody. Enjoy.
Okay, so we're on to the printed pages. We're going to do a little Beatles. Hello, goodbye. All right. And then we'll do a few more songs. And maybe I'll bring a bunch of you on to say goodbye at the end of the night. We'll have a little conversational, little chat at the end. So, but, I mean, between all the cooking and the singing and the special guests we have tonight, I don't know. So this one was another suggestion from Terry. I'm going to be honest with you, when we get into the why's, I'm probably going to fudge it a bit. I was working on this. I got like two songs on this additional list song that I got to kind of fudge a little bit. So just kind of follow along, you know. All right. So I got my pedal, my Bluetooth is working. I have one beat tonight, so if you're all waiting for the band in the box to come out, it's the next song. All right, the mellow song. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. You say. All right, so let's try that again. You say yes. There it is. It's a D. Ready, 1, 2, 3, 4. You say yes, I say no. You say stop, and I say go, go, go. Oh no, you say goodbye, and I say hello. Hello, hello. I don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. Say goodbye, I say hello. You say hi, I say low. You say why, and I say I don't know. Oh no, you say goodbye, and I say hello. Hello, hello. I don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. Hello, hello. I don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. Goodbye, I say hello. Hello, hello. I don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. You say yes, I say no. You say stop, and I say go, go, go. Oh no, you say goodbye, and I say hello. Hello, hello. Don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. Hello, hello. I don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. Hello, hello. I don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. Hello, hello. I don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. Hello, hello, hey, bo, bo, hello, hello, ba, hello, hello, hey, bo, hello, hey, bo, hello. All right. Hello, goodbye. All right. So we're going to move on to I'm So Lonesome I Could Cry. All right. So this was actually a Hank Williams song, but I discovered it on YouTube. BJ Thomas did a cover of this song. And Elvis was quoted to saying, "I'm about to sing the saddest song I've ever heard." So we're going to play one time through the little intro, which the chords there, one time through those chords. And then it's a nice little waltz. It'll give you a little, I got a 4-beat introduction on my little drum machine here. The saddest song we've ever sung, but it's pretty sad. But it's a nice tune. All right. So I did a little beat. Like maybe it might get me into this a little bit. I don't know what possessed me. I know what possessed me to do this song. Shake It Off. It's a Taylor Swift song. It was one of her first songs to come out as one of her poppy songs, and was kind of a chat with, you know, kind of an answer to everyone kind of criticizing her about her love life. I think at one time, every time she broke up with a guy, she wrote a song and she had a number one hit with it. So I think this was the first one that she did with that. I was practicing it last night and Raven came down and just gave me this like look, like, really, you're gonna do this song? But what inspired me to do this song was I had posted on Facebook on Kazoo Day, on national or international or whatever. We had a bunch of international days this past week, but it was National Kazoo Play Your Kazoo Day last week. And our good friends north of the border, up at Walk Off the Earth, do these wonderful covers of these songs, and they do ukulele a lot, but they also use kazoos a lot. So they did this song, and they played the horn part with the kazoos, and I just kind of liked it, and I was like thinking, we can do this song, until I started doing it, and quite honestly, I'll kind of muddle through the little rap part in the middle. Cause the player's gonna play, 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 and the hater's gonna hate, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake it off, shake it off. My breaker, breaker's gonna break, 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 and the taker's gonna fake, 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 fake. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake it off, shake it off. Never miss a beat. Lightning on my feet. That's what they don't see. That's what they don't see. Dancing on my own, dancing on my own. Make the moves I go, make them go, go. What they don't know, what they don't know. But I keep cruising, I can't stop this grooving. Like I got this music in my mind, saying it's gonna be alright. Cause the player's gonna play, 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 and the hater's gonna hate, 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 maybe. And it's just gonna shake, 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 shake it off, shake it off. Heartbreaker's gonna break, 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 and the taker's gonna fake, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake it off, shake it off, shake it off. I shake it off, I shake it off, I shake it off. Shake it off, shake it off. All right, here comes the rap. I just don't know. Hey, just thinking. Well, I've never been good at rapping. While you're out there out, but the liars and the dirty cheats of the world, and you can be getting down with this sick beat. My ex-man and his new girlfriend. She's like, oh my God, I'm gonna shake it off. To the fella over there with the hella good hair. Well, I'm gonna come, baby. I'm gonna shake, 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 shake. Cause the player's gonna play, 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 play. And the hater's gonna hate, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake. Shake it off, shake it off. Heartbreaker's gonna break, 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 break. And the faker's gonna fake, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake. Shake it off. I shake it off, I shake it off, I shake it off, shake it off, I shake it off, I shake it off, shake it off, I shake it off, shake it off, shake it off, shake it off, I shake it off, shake it off, I shake it off, shake it off. I'm ending it there. Anyone wants to do that when we go out, you're more than welcome to do it. You're more than welcome to do it. All right, I got a thumbs up. I got a thumbs up from Terry. Well, maybe Terry will take that on. She can practice that when we can do it. All right, so the last song we got is a little Paul Simon, Kodachrome. Film you cannot get developed anymore. There was a rumor about Kodachrome, like when he says everything looks better in black and white, was because no matter what you took the picture with Kodachrome, there was this like wash of color. It was like this like over the top saturated color thing going on with it. So a lot of people didn't like it, and a lot of professional photographers, even though they used it, had to use all these weird filters. So it was almost like, what's the point? I don't know. It was about 10, 15 years ago. There was one lab that still had the last chemicals. So if you got any Kodachrome sticking in old Kodachrome, no one can develop it. All right, that's our little intro, right? Ready? I should have worked on a beat for this one, but I didn't. When I think back on all the crap I learned in high school, it's a wonder I can think at all. Although my lack of education hasn't hurt me none, I can read the writing on the wall. Kodachrome, give me those nice bright colors. Give me the greens of summer. Makes you think all the world of a sunny day. I got a Nikon camera, love to take a photograph, so mama don't take my Kodachrome away. If you took all the girls I knew when I was single, brought them all together for one night, I know they never match my sweet imagination. Everything looks worse in black and white. Kodachrome, give me the nice bright colors. Give me the greens of summer. Makes you think all the world of a sunny day. Oh yeah, I got a Nikon camera, love to take a photograph, so mama don't take my Kodachrome away. Well, mama don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama don't take my Kodachrome. Mama don't take my Kodachrome. Mama don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama don't take my Kodachrome. Leave your boy so far from home. Mama don't take my Kodachrome away. Hey, mama don't take my Kodachrome. Woo, woo. Mama don't take my Kodachrome away. I'm going to bring Greg in to say goodnight. And I've got Kristen, you want to come on and say goodnight to everyone? You were hanging out there in my green room all the time. I got Terry.
Hi, Kristen.
I mean, I don't know how many people I can put on the screen here.
Kristen.
And Tom. Oh, look at this. Look at all this.
Hey,
oh,
Terry.
You got that drink. I got Uncle Zach throwing one back here. Everyone that hung out to the end. I want to thank you all for coming on. As always, I want to thank everyone out there for hanging out. But as we said, Tom, maybe in a month we might be all back together outside, indoors, outside, masked up, but at least we'll be all together. I will keep streaming, though, as always. I will still keep the stream going on. But so,
Steve, thank you very much for everything, man. You're keeping us together.
I thanks for showing up every week. I mean, and tuning in. I mean, that's what really counts. I mean, I'd be.
And thank
I keep
you
joking about it. I turned the camera on. I'd be sitting down here in my basement doing this anyway. So, all right, everyone, have a great night. I will see everyone when we can. Look forward. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Be good, everyone. Thanks.
Hello, enjoy the show.
Bye. Bye. See you soon.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Good night. Thank you for
good night, everyone. Fun.